In the previous class, we discussed Kohlrausch law and the relationship between the molar conductance and equivalent conductance at infinite dilution. Okay. So now in this lecture, we are going to discuss Kohlrausch law and applications. Okay. Here I am going to explain somewhat applications based on Kohlrausch law. So one of the major applications from Kohlrausch law, by using Kohlrausch law, it is possible to calculate equivalent and molar conductance of weak electrolytes at infinite dilution. Okay, so first application I am giving here, calculation of lambda m naught or lambda equivalent naught, nothing but the molar conductance or equivalent conductance at infinite dilution, or you know that when I am keeping like this at zero concentration, both are the same terms. Or we can also call that limiting molar conductance or limiting equivalent conductance. Okay, so calculation of lambda m naught or lambda equivalent of weak electrolytes. Okay, so generally when you studied about the strong electrolytes, okay, we are calculated the lambda m naught and the lambda equivalent by using Debye-Okell-Ansager equation. Yes or no? So we have a formula lambda m C at particular concentration, lambda m naught minus A root C we are given. Okay. So when we are plotting that a graph between lambda m, okay, molar conductance and whatever the root C concentration term, we are getting that a negative slope. So the extrapolated curve usually gives the lambda m naught value. Okay. So clear. But this experimentally, when you are calculating for that a weak electrolyte, we are getting the curve like this. Okay. So this curve is responsible for that a strong electrolyte. But the curve, whatever I am given here, it is a weak electrolyte. Here I have not a chance to extrapolate this curve. So here we are not getting the lambda m naught by using this experimental values. Okay. So, but it is possible to calculate lambda m naught and lambda equivalent naught for weak electrolytes, okay, by using Kohlrausch law. So, generally when you want to calculate the lambda m naught or lambda equivalent for weak electrolyte, here I am taking that lambda m naught for acetic acid. Suppose I want to calculate that. So, according to Kohlrausch law, what you get that? Here it will be produced lambda naught of CH3COO minus lambda naught of H plus. So generally here I am given, by that experimentally it is not possible to calculate the lambda m naught or lambda equivalent naught. Okay, why? Because weak electrolytes, even though at infinite dilution, it will not produce the total number of ions. And these weak electrolytes have the less amount of the conductance. So that's why we are not possible to calculate. So here I am going to calculate with the help of this strong electrolyte conductance values. Okay. So strong electrolyte conductance values I am using. So for example, I am giving here lambda m naught of CH3COOH we want to calculate. So according to Kohlrausch law, we have that formula lambda naught of CH3COO minus lambda naught of H plus. So already you know that Kohlrausch law, just now I am giving in the previous lecture. So what is the Kohlrausch law? The equivalent of the molar conductance, here I am expressing in molar conductance, the molar conductance of an electrolyte at infinite dilution or at zero concentration must be equal to sum of cation and anion conductance values. Okay. So here to calculate this one, I am utilizing three strong electrolytes. Okay. So here I am using lambda m naught of CH3COONa, sodium acetate, and lambda naught of NaCl and lambda m naught of HCl. Okay. So I am utilizing three. By using these three strong electrolytes, I am going to calculate here. So that mathematical expression I am doing that somewhat. You know that according to Kohlrausch law, lambda m naught of CH3COONa gives lambda m naught of CH3COO minus plus lambda m naught of Na plus. Clear? So we are getting the lambda m naught Na plus. So at the same time, similar way, I am giving further lambda m naught of sodium chloride, lambda m naught of Na plus, plus lambda m naught of Cl minus. Yes or no? And at the same way, lambda m naught of HCl is gives us to lambda m naught H plus, it is equals to okay lambda m naught of Cl minus. So I am using these three values, okay, by doing some mathematical expressions, okay, mathematical calculation. I am going to calculate this one, okay. So for example, if I am doing this along with respect to these three, lambda m naught CH3COOMa plus lambda m naught NaCl minus lambda m naught HCl. Okay, if I am doing that CH3COOH, if I want to get that, okay, so here we require the CH3COO minus and H plus. So that's why I am making that a mathematical expression here, the positive plus, here I am making that a negative sign. Okay, carefully observe, we require that only CH3COO minus term and H plus term, the remaining we don't require. Okay, so when you are writing for this according to KOHLRAUSCH law, so what do you get that here? Lambda naught of CH3COO minus plus lambda naught of Na plus. So here minus of lambda naught of Na plus minus of lambda naught of Cl minus and plus lambda naught of H plus plus lambda naught of Cl minus. So here plus lambda naught Na plus minus lambda naught Na plus minus lambda naught Cl minus plus lambda naught Cl minus. What we left here? Lambda naught of CH3CO minus lambda naught of H plus. So finally, we got that lambda naught of CH3COO minus plus lambda naught of H plus. It must be equals to lambda naught of CH3COOH. So here we are calculating indirectly the weak electrolyte equivalent conductances or molar conductances at infinite dilution by using that equivalent conductance or molar conductance of strong electrolyte. Okay, so this is I am explained by that only KOHLRAUSCH law. Got it? So why we are is not possible to calculate by the graphical representation or experimental? Why? Because the weak electrolytes, even at that infinite dilution, these are not participating in complete dissociation. Okay, so that's why we are calculating these values by using KOHLRAUSCH law. Okay, now let's see that second application. Let's see second one. Here the calculation of degree of dissociation. Okay, calculation of degree of dissociation, usually we represent with alpha. Okay, degree of dissociation. So here that alpha we are calculating with the help of this KOHLRAUSCH law. Okay, we are defining the degree of dissociation is nothing but it is the ratio of molar conductance or equivalent conductance at any concentration. Okay, molar conductance at any concentration to molar conductance at infinite dilution. At infinite dilution. Otherwise, it is also possible, right? That molar conductance at zero concentration. Okay, or we can also call limiting molar conductance. Clear? So here I express it with respect to molar conductance. Otherwise, it is also possible to write equivalent conductance. The ratio of equivalent conductance at any concentration to equivalent conductance at infinite dilution or at zero concentration. Okay. So the ratio between that molar conductance at any concentration to that molar conductance at infinite dilution usually gives the degree of dissociation. Okay. So this lambda m naught and lambda equivalent naught, from where we are calculating? By using only KOHLRAUSCH law. So first application I am given the calculation of the lambda m naught and lambda equivalent naught for weak electrolyte. Okay. So now let's see the third one, the calculation or the determination of dissociation constant. Okay, so determination of a dissociation constant, or we can also call ionization constant. Okay, dissociation constant or ionization constant. So here we are dealing with respect of either weak acids or weak bases. So generally we are represent with respect to Ka or Kb. Okay, so Ka or Kb we are calculating. We are calculating by using KOHLRAUSCH. So the simple mathematical expression, we are showing that Ka or Kb is equals to C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. Okay, Ka is equals to C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. What is alpha? Alpha is equals to degree of dissociation. C is equals to the given concentration. Okay, so when we are simplifying this equation, the mathematical expression, alpha is equals to what we have, that lambda mc by lambda m naught. Okay, so I am writing that lambda m at any concentration by lambda m naught whole square by. Okay, so what is 1 minus alpha? What we have, that 1 minus lambda m at c by lambda m naught. Clear? So when we are simplifying this one, we get that c into lambda m c whole square by lambda m naught whole square. Okay, 1 minus lambda m c by lambda m naught. So make that simplification here. We get that lambda m naught minus lambda m c by lambda m naught. So here these two are going to get cancelled. So finally what we have, that Kb is equals to C into lambda m C whole square by lambda m naught into lambda m naught minus lambda m at n C. Okay. So this is the mathematical expression we are using to calculate that, are determining the dissociation constant or ionization constants of weak acids or weak bases. Usually we are representing with Ka, Kb. Okay, so these three are the simple and major applications of the KOHLRAUSCH. So in the next lecture, I am going to explain about the solubility and the solubility product. Okay, so how to determine the solubility and solubility product by using KOHLRAUSCH. Okay, so we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.